So when I came back from Japan in 2007, I really didn't have much idea about how we were going to work with Zen practice in the Western world. But one thing I was very clear about was we couldn't just transplant the Japanese style of doing things. Even in Japan, people sometimes used to ask me about what's the connection between this kind of very hard life and finding happiness? How does living such a hard life help you to find happiness? They couldn't make that connection, and I think even less so here in the Western world. So it's been about how to find ways that people here in the West can access what Zen is really about within a context that makes sense. And what I found is the framework of Zen Master Hakuin, where he talks about the two wings of a bird to be a very fruitful kind of overarching way of approaching practice. So we have one wing of the bird, which is really about practices which are geared towards insight, towards finding out who you really are. And as we do this, as we develop this more refined, more penetrating view, we start to see how we really are. We access a source of happiness that isn't dependent on external conditions. It's not something that anybody can give you, nor that anybody can ever take away from you. It's yours. So that's this one wing of the bird. And then the other aspect, the other wing of the bird, are a sequence of practices that Hakuin learned up in the mountains from a hermit, which are about how to, as it were, live an empowered and energized and grounded life. So it's not enough just to find the truth. You need enough oomph, enough pouvoir, if you like, to be able to live out that truth. Now, many people have some sense of that first wing of the bird, how meditation, and particularly in the Zen context, how Zen meditation practice can lead to deep and sustaining insights. The second wing of the bird, the grounding, energizing, empowering practices, aren't something that's so familiar. Key within Zen is this term hara, which probably translates best as guts. When we think of guts in a language sense, we talk in English about a gutsy person, somebody who's got guts. And we also talk about somebody who has perhaps a gut feeling, like an intuition. Perhaps the difference in the sense of guts and hara, East and West, is that within Japan, there's a sense that this quality of hara is something that can be cultivated, can be developed. As this develops, you take on a more energized, grounded quality. You also take on a kind of presence and charisma. And that's obviously of great advantage in life in general. So within our Zenway's way of practice, we essentially were working towards integrating these two wings of a bird, or giving people these two wings of a bird so that they can incorporate them into their lives within this Western context to live the best life that they're actually able to live, a life that's based in the greatest good, really, a life of service.